The 2017 Australian Grand Prix at Phillip Island saw mixed weather conditions throughout the weekend and in turn a big number of crashes. In total, 86 riders hit the deck over the course of 3 days, with 17 in MotoGP, 27 in Moto3, and a whopping 42 in Moto2, with Turn 4's Honda Hairpin seeing the greatest number of fallers at 21. First up is Moto2 as Marcel Schrotter runs wide and high sides, leaving nowhere for pole setter Mattia Pessini to go, resulting in them both crashing out of the race. On board we ride as we see Schrotter being thrown from the bike and collected by Pessini, with the duo being incredibly lucky to escape serious injury. Moto3 at the Honda hairpin now as Giordanillo outbrakes himself and careers into the side of Aaron Canet, as we see in slow motion. It was a big shame for both riders, especially Canet, however, as he had good race pace up until that point. Turn 6 of Siberia and a wet track in FP3 as Marc Marquez runs out of grip on his front tyre and slides into the gravel trap. The 5-time world champion did manage to pick up his bike from the gravel and get back out on the track later in the session. Sunday morning warm-up in Moto2 as we see Tom Lüthi, the Swiss rider, high-siding in a spectacular way on the wet circuit. As we can see, he was collected by the bike and then barrel-rolled through the gravel. It was an incredibly difficult weekend for the title contender. The same corner as Jorge Lorenzo loses the front this time and had a very violent trip through the gravel trap before coming to a stop. As we ride on board with the Spaniard, we get an idea of how quickly it went wrong, with Jorge suffering from a sprained ankle following the incident. Next up, we look at the downhill hairpin of MG, with Johan Zarco losing the rear mid-corner before it regains grip and high-sides him off of the bike. It didn't deter the Yamaha Tech 3 rider, however, as he made several aggressive passes during the race, as we can watch the incident from on board. Now it's title chaser Dobby's turn to grace the tarmac as he locks the front and hits the deck, sliding a long way before coming to a stop. It was a difficult weekend for Ducati, with their results not matching Yamaha or Honda. And finally, we look at title contender Romano Fenati having a huge high side in free practice, with Jakob Kornfeil having to take evasive action. That was a look at some of the crashes from Australia. Join us in Malaysia on the 29th of October.